map is 88%. Alright, I'm loading it. I think. How do you tell?
Yeah. Go back.
Stop.
Everybody got a map, man.
Stop, pal.
Yeah, I think it's done now, but well,
really, yeah, it's pretty done. I knew, but I like it. Like, damn, you know, she's gonna be like that. Hold on, boy, get the map.
So thanks for being with us. Let's get right.
Targets in sight. Contact with the enemy. Contact.
Capture the objectives. Enemy taking E. We're capturing A. Enemy has Echo. We captured A. We're capturing B.
Enemy contact.
We're capturing D.
Contact. Enemy. Down.
Enemy taking Charlie.
Enemy in sight. Contact with enemy. Targets in sight.
We captured Delta. Enemy. enemy taking Delta. We've taken the lead. Capturing Echo.
Enemy.
Missile inbound. We're capturing E. We captured E. Hostile hunter killer drone inbound. Our sentry gun has been destroyed. Enemy taking Bravo. Enemy has Bravo. We lost A.
Enemy contact gun!
Hostile sentry gun spotted. Enemy sentry gun has been destroyed. Capturing Alpha. Enemy airstrike incoming. Be careful. Be careful. Enemy swarm activate. We're capturing Echo. Losing C. Enemy's hunter killer. We lost Charlie. We're being dominated. Take those positions. Hostile sentry gun in your AO. Heads up, team. Enemy UAV spotted. Super close. Fight harder. We're capturing A. We're capturing Bravo. We captured Alpha.
Get down, Sniper!
Killer drone deployed. Losing Alpha.
Contact with enemy.
Enemy is taking the mega point. UAV online. Losing A. airstrike incoming. Be careful. We're capturing Delta.
Enemy contact!
UAV recon ready for deployment. We're capturing C. Losing Alpha. We lost C. Hostile Predator missile inbound. Enemy UAV spotted. We're capturing E.
Enemy contact!
We're capturing D. Captured Echo.
Enemy
fight! UAV online. We captured D. Be advised, hostile sentry gun spotted. Friendly napalm deployed.
Any of Melly's clothing from that night. This comes from Delmar Durham from YouTube.
You listen to the defense and their opening, the answer is no, they did not search for clothing of anyone, frankly. They did have a t-shirt in that car. I think it belonged to Anthony, if I'm not mistaken. And they did do some DNA analysis on that t-shirt, the front of the t-shirt and the back of the t-shirt. But one of the things that the defense said during their opening was, look, they did not follow up on anything as far as Henry was concerned, as far as Melly was concerned, no clothing. And so the answer to the question is, it doesn't seem as though they really followed up on what was in the car other than, you know, some of the bottles and some of the shoes and nothing that the defendants, and as you know, Henry is one of the co-defendants, that case has been severed, but I haven't seen any evidence of any analysis of the clothing that either of the defendants was wearing.
Okay, Goody Green from YouTube. Why does Melly, Michael Bryant, need three defense lawyers?
Well, there's no rule about how many you need or have to have. And sometimes a case is broken down into subparts so that certain attorneys will handle a certain number of witnesses. Maybe there's somebody who does just the medical, somebody who does just the cell phone data, maybe somebody who does just the DNA. So I don't know, you know, is it a show of force? Is it like, hey, let's see how many attorneys I've got, how many do you guys have? I don't think it's that.
exactly where any of those bullets went. I think the prosecution tried to show with those diagrams, but I think the defense did a good job saying, look, you haven't showed us anything because there are just so many variables that you don't know. I think the witness actually said, you're right, it's not true.
Abby 18 from YouTube, Michael. Will his reputation and persona affect his outcome despite the evidence? What do you think, Michael? Is this Melly's, who he is, his persona, gonna affect this at all?
So you would like to hope the jury voir dire, you know, every prospective jury member was not only death qualified if they need to reach this case, but also those biases were explored. You know, there's so many cases, so many stories about those in the music business, you know, having these violent encounters. You know, this is not a rare story exactly. It's more interesting because it's really truly a whodunit. This defendant in this case, I think they'd have to overlook a lack of evidence to get there at this point. But yeah, of course, these background.